first round finishes. We're set for 3 by 5 minute rounds. The Aussie in the blue, the Filipino in the red. Jab two early on here from Lightning Reese McLaren.
Kevin Belingon is known for that lightning fast front kick that seems to come out of nowhere. Just how long until he throws it?
McLaren had an 8-week camp on Australia's Gold Coast up north in Queensland. Said he worked on bridging the gap between his striking to his takedowns. Jab two again and a double jab from Reese McLaren.
Reese McLaren immediately starts with the taunting. Oh, what a right hand!
Beautiful right hand from Belingon. McLaren in trouble. Here comes Belingon. Could it be the GoDaddy knockout of the night on the way? Belingon driving in the left hand, driving in the right hand. And McLaren reaches up, pulls him down. He's got to control the posture. He's got to stop the ground and pound.
Those are some huge shots thrown by Belingon, but what heart by McLaren to hang in there. Avoided a lot of shots, but took a lot in the process. Belingon just put it on him till Olivier was forced to jump in and stop the contest.
Look out for the hands on Belingon. Massive meat hooks. Can Chung get him down and negate the boxing? Cannot stand in the pocket and go toe-to-toe with Belingon.
Chung says movement is what he's really focused on in this preparation for this match. He's got to move left and right, and right now he's standing right in front of Belingon, which is, it sounds like the worst idea in the world to me. He's got to get on that bicycle, create movement. I like how he's switching stances, giving him a bit different looks. Man, that was a hammer of a left kick. Looked like it was a little bit low. You didn't quite see it. I think we might have to check a look at that replay, because that sounded like it was all the meat of the thigh.
Accidental groin strike there from Kevin Belingon. Take a look at this again. Throws the inside thigh kick. I have just clipped the cup there on Chung, and Chung will get some recovery time. Look at Belingon, as always, comes in supremely fit. Massive traps, massive deltoids on this little powerful man.
We've got an injury timeout, but Michael, we are. Here you go. Break down the injury timeout for him.
There will be 5 minutes allotted here for Chung to recover and receive medical examination. If he's unable to continue after that 5 minutes, well, we really haven't gone far enough to call a decision in this contest, Mitch.
I know. What we have here, we have a very special opportunity to finally be able to speak to Brandon, the truth, Vera, the one heavyweight world champion. We're supposed to bring him in between rounds, but no match has gone past the first round. At the night, how you doing, Brandon?
I'm good. It's kind of been an easy night for me over here. Thank you for having me again. Kamusta lahat? Hello, kababayan. Good to hear from you. Good to see you guys.
Brandon, I got to say, this is my first time ever in Manila, and they are crazy for one championship. How awesome is this place?
This is so loud. It's so amazing.
We're back underway in the first round. Chung has recovered, and Belingon presses with the jab. Fight from Belingon. Oh, look, chin on Getty! Turning back kick. Looks for the liver of Chung.
Really connected to that right side. Just barely missed the button there to shut down the body.
Island roundhouse from Kevin Chung. The crowd on the edge of their seats for this one. A sellout crowd inside the Mall of Asia Arena. Belingon setting the right hand, the big tub thumper. Chung backs up, now he edges forward. A composed fight from Belingon so far.
Left hand's pretty low on Chung.
Oh, he swung wildly and spun himself around with that missed left hand. Spinning back kick again, hunts after the liver of Chung. You hit the liver and you hit that phrenic nerve, and really you close down the entire body. Overhand right there from Chung.
Gotta be careful, because look, right now, Kevin Belingon is gonna beat up that leg with those kicks and then go headhunting.
Belingon is holding nothing back with these strikes. The crowd is cheering with everything Belingon throws, and you see how Chung looks to be protecting the left side of his body. It looks like that right kick hurt him earlier on.
He's got to protect every side of his body because these angles that Belingon throws strikes from everywhere.
Alongside the middleweight world champion, barking instructions from Troop's corner.
For the takedown, he can't keep it just like that. He can't stand there and let Kevin Belingon unload like this.
Kevin Belingon will kick for the corner spot. Show him trouble. Here comes Belingon. Is he going to drop the head? The big right hand. The ground and pound now. Troop throws a leg shot, pushes him back.
Tom's got a good guard. He might be able to catch him with an armbar and triangle here. But look at the way Kevin just, like Belingon, lunges at him, dropping these shots. He's so dominant from the top position.
And Troop found a way to tie up Belingon on the ground. Belingon scoots around, tries a knee to the sternum. Bolo pump to the head. Troop slides up to his back. Belingon double look count. Side control, north-south position. Throws a knee to the head. Troop calls the cover up. Belingon unloading on him. Big leg cannon. Troop does a quick count of his teeth. This is all Belingon. It's all the silencer. It's all one-way traffic. This crowd going bananas for Belingon here in Manila.
Look at the impatience of Belingon picking each one of his shots, not dumping everything into a flurry. He's calculating with his striking attacks and his ground and pound, picking apart chunks very, very slowly and methodically.
Belingon resets. Chunks still on his back. Swings the legs now, does the silencer. Gotta watch those kicks to the left knee from Kevin Chung.
Belingon should let him up. Belingon should let him up.
Is he gonna let him up? Is he just toying? Is he just playing? Yuji Shimada allows Chung to his feet. What can Chung do now? Can he get Belingon on his back? He throws a high right roundhouse. Belingon looks to return the favor. The man with the mightiest mullet in all of martial arts has done an absolute number on Kevin Chung here in the first round.
36 seconds in the first round.
These shots that Kevin Belingon, these one-hitter quitters, are scaring me over here in the commentary booth, Michael.
Belingon has had one of the most insane opening rounds we've ever seen from this crazy Filipino. Outside leg kick from Chung.
Spinning back fist from Belingon. Agonizing the close. Yeah, Chung's got to bring up his guard. He's got to protect the head. Oh, deep leg kick right there to end the round. That was complete striking superiority. Look at that beautifully timed spinning back kick. Just had so much force and spun him around on that hook. Here's some of the ground and pound where he was just laying in.
They're getting a bit closer this time. I think they're getting a bit closer. They're not going to be so gun-shy, I hope. I hope they're going to be able to close the distance. They're doing the same thing again. They're back stuck in their tracks. But maybe it's the start of every round this will happen. And, you know, they warm up as the round goes on. Maybe that's what's happening with these two fighters. And as a fighter, every single fighter you face, you have a different strategy or a different feel. If you're up against a Muay Thai guy, they may be pushing forwards all the time, causing you, if you're a counter-striker, to react and to strike back. But these two are both standing off. Maybe they're both counter-strikers, but neither of them are pushing forwards enough to spark the other one's interest.
But with the ease that Gafurov was able to take Belingon down, pass his guard, and end up in mount, you think that would be the first thing on his mind as we just lost 60 seconds around three.
Indeed, you know, he needs to do the same thing again. If he could just start walking forward, push the fight to the cage and get a takedown against the cage, that would be fantastic. But he appears to want to strike in the center of the cage. And that's where Kevin Belingon is having a lot of success in this fight.
Yeah, I spoke to Moon Gafurov's coaches, and he says he just doesn't follow the game plan because he gets so one-tracked into his focus, and he just wants to stand and bang with people, and he loses sight of the overall strategy, and that looks to be what's happening now, because if he could slide in for another one of these takedowns, he could end the fight here quickly, but he's choosing to go at Kevin's strength, which is the stand-up.
I know, and you know, that's not what he wants to do. He has to set up and go in for a takedown. the crowd here is reacting to these two fighters standing in the middle of the cage, not throwing any strikes out. Kevin Belingon trying to get that inside leg kick again. I mean, you know, we want to see more action from this for sure, but I mean, Kevin Belingon, it looks like he's doing damage to that left leg of Tadjic.
Yeah, this crowd is, look at this, sold out to Wana Stadium. It is absolutely packed here in Myanmar, and they are just on the edge of their seat. Beautiful inside leg kick. That has been, got to be like the 15th time he's landed that shot, Peter.
It must be. It must be at least. Kevin Belingon is getting rushed. It looks like he's going for a dust choke. He's not got quite enough of his arm in there. Kevin Belingon throwing strikes, elbowing out of that clinch position there. And they're back in the center of the cage, throwing the inside leg again. Muin Gafurov has to go in and shoot for a takedown. He has to set that up and do that. You know, he's really, really got to change things up if he wants to win this fight. He only has just over 2 minutes to do that. And if he doesn't, I believe he might have lost this fight.
His coaches are just screaming at him to shoot him for the takedown and push forward, but it's almost like he's got tunnel vision and he wants to stand and strike, and Kevin Belingon is following the strategy perfectly.
He is indeed. And maybe Muin Gafurov is, you know, he's a little bit scared to go in. He's felt a bit of the leather already. He knows that inside leg kick is causing damage. Muin is having a little bit of trouble moving forwards. And you know, you see, he went in for the takedown, but he ducked from a very far distance. He didn't change level. Maybe his leg hurts too much to be able to do that and then shoot in. And then Kevin Belingon again gets his head on the back of the chest, and that's what we've seen several times.
Good defense by Kevin Belingon. Now we're starting to see why Team Lakai is on a massive 15-fight win streak. It is just so impressive the way that they formulate their strategy. We got 1 minute left, Peter, but as you well know, 1 minute in the ONE Championship cage is a long time.
It is a huge amount of time. It is an absolute eternity. I think, however, unless Muin Gafurov gets a knockout or a flash submission, if he can do the same takedown he just did, get Kevin Bellingon's head under his chest, maybe he can go for like a double-handed, like a sort of a guillotine. If he could just do that same thing again, if maybe he has that move in his artillery, it would be fantastic. But otherwise, Kevin Belingon is going to increase Team Leke's win streak by one.
The crowd is igniting, on fire here. They are cheering to see more action from these two explosive bantamweights, and they look just as fresh as they did in the final minute as they do in the first.
Hey, they do indeed. Kevin Belingon just shying away from a spinning back fist there. That inside leg kick, body shots. Oh my goodness, you can still hear it from here. It's not like these two are not working hard, but there is the end of round three and our fight.
As we look at some of this back action, talk us through some of this stuff.
That was a massive outside leg kick with full weight from Kevin Belingon, throwing his opponent to the ground. Inside leg kicks, these are the things that again, the outside, these are the two strikes which have played a big role in Kevin Belingon potentially winning this fight, if our judges see it that way.
By unanimous decision from the blue corner, Kevin Belingon!
Singapore has been a happy hunting ground for Bibiano Fernandes. It was here in 2013 that he won the title, or to unify the one bantamweight world title, by Benny Sutul Kim. Oh, good right hand, stiffly there from Belingon. Bibi tries to thread the right hook, turning back into the liver. Bibi backs it up with the right hand. Get the takedown, and we're back in Bibi land, the half guard position. Let's see what Fernandes can do. The takedown has come early in the second round.
And we were set up with the hands. He was able to utilize the boxing, back Kevin up with the big right hand, get him up against the cage, and now he's grinding on him. Now Bibiano's going to start to slowly and methodically work on Kevin. He's got to slow him down a little bit. He's got to get Kevin to expend some energy. Kevin is extremely explosive. That's how he got out of the first exchange here on the ground. He was able to just throw Bibi off on him.
Let's go, guys.
The explosion, the fast twitch muscle fiber of Kevin Belingon is at an all-time high. Bibiano needs to slow him down.
and it's going to serve well mentally for Kevin Belingon that he's out of the first round. Last time they met in 2016, Bibiano tapped out Belingon with a Kimura in just 4 minutes and 4 seconds. Here he is in the second round, and Belingon told us, I'm a completely different martial arts machine than I was last time we fought.
Every single one of Team Nakai always excels in the rematch. They go back, they've got their head coach who breaks everything down, and they always find a way to be much more successful in the second time
around. Fence.
When they run it back, Team Nakai, second team.
Now we're on 19 and 5, 11 finishes, including 8 knockouts, 9 of those in the very first round. Scramble here. Going on back to his feet. Seems to be overwhelming Filipino support for Kevin Belingon in the crowd here in Singapore tonight.
And again, he exploded out of the technique.
And the chance go up for Kevin Belingon, the underdog here in Singapore. Spinning back to Speedy Avenger, tries to elude the attack, and Belingon gets out of the way. What a matchup for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. It's one championship, Heart of the Lion, live from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Got the right hand cocked and ready here, Belingon. Shifts off to his left. Bibi dead center of the cage. Jab there from Fernandes. Belingon taking his time. Very patient match so far from Belingon. Overhand right misses.
Everything Kevin throws is full force. There's no waiting out process, no setup. Everything is just one big shot trying to take that head off of Bibiano Fernandes. But good eyes from the veteran. He's moving out well. And so Kevin is extending.
He got airborne on that! Jump turning back kick to the belly button of Bibiano Fernandes. He must have been half a foot off the ground, Nick. That was incredible.
You hear the crash that side kick.
Take down there from Fernandes. Now the Brazilian, up the intensity, up the aggression, takes the back of Belingon. Here's Bibiano. This is what Fernandes does so well. The body triangle locked on. And Belingon's got no place to go. Belingon could be in trouble here. Bibiano goes for the arm. Goes for the arm. Goes for the arm. Can he find the finish? Belingon's in trouble.
Kevin Belingon pushed the leg off of Bibiano. A straight escape. Threw the arm off. Or threw the leg off, rather. Saved the arm. But Bibiano still can't even accept the arm off.
This place going bananas! The ground and pound from Belingon!
Bibiano is covered up. A lot of this is covered off. Those landed right there, though. Bibiano's laughing. He's okay.
Have a look at Belingon. It's a knockdown in Singapore.
Bibiano still attacking off his back. Threw up an armbar attempt right there. Now he's got the high guard. Look for him to go for a triangle. He's got one arm trapped there on the side. He's going to let it go. He's still got the arm trapped. Looking for the arm bar.
Belingon gets up some shots.
Kevin, he survived the back. Look at Bibi. Look at the way he's trapped that right left arm. Throws the leg over. Look at Kevin. Get off me. Get that leg off me. He's okay. I'm okay. Get that leg off. Bibiano covers back up. Still has that arm trapped. Look how he traps the arm with his leg. Hooks in like he's doing a hamstring curl. Completely has the arm trapped. Uses his right arm to attempt it again. Goes after it again. Kevin shrugs him off.
Ready? Go!
Touch blocks. Second round set for 3. Scored as an overall contest, but no doubt it's one that Belingon is clearly leading at the moment. What happens? That sense of intrigue if Leone can put Belingon on his back. Hasn't happened yet. Belingon scoring 2 takedowns in the opening round, or 2 times putting Leone on his back. Leone served them counterclockwise.
That's good. He's got to stay away from circling to that wrong side. If he keeps circling right, keeps moving to Belingon's left side, that's going to avoid that big right hand.
Belingon pivoting center ring, doesn't want to give it up here. Again, Belingon like a ticking time bomb. Okay. Could explode at any moment. Oh, turn it back, kick drops him! Turn it back, kick drops him! Turn it back, kick drops him! Here comes Belingon! Manila in a meltdown! That was awesome! A turning back kick to the liver! Dropped there, Drew Leone! And now the aggression, the ground and pound, the unloading, the assault, the burnout, the good night, Irene!
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.